And we continue with the same tikkun, tikkun vav, tikkun six tikkun, with the shiluach haken, and to explain the whole concept of sending the birds. That's the name of the mitzvah. Shiluach haken can mean a nest, and we talked so far about the birds. But the birds represent the Shechina. But if we talk about eggs, or if we talk about chicks, or if we talk about sons, different category. So we continue. What shalach to shalach? Od yesh tam mitzvah shiluach haken. Tachezi malachai de mamana lofin deilu nafshi nekut ziperin. There is an angel that in charge of those birds that we call tziporim, that we call small birds. Lefi shem mipchanat malchut da'asiya, because they coming from malchut in the system level that called asiya. Asiya system is the world of action. Anikret tzipor kadal, v'amalach hazeh hu sandal shmeh, and the angel, like we say before, who is in charge of that, name is Sandal. That's his name. ובזמנת ישראל מקיימים אי פקודת שילוח הקן, and when the Israelites are doing the mitzvah of שילוח הקן, they are actively making sure that they're doing that specific mitzvah, וזאת אימא מתרחה, ואיפה של הפרוחים ששלחו מהקן שלה הולכת מגורשת מטורפת. Think about the physical idea of the mitzvah, not just the spiritual or the mystical meaning. When you actually push a bird away from her eggs or chicks or her sons, what do you think happened to the mother? Said to us, Tikkunei Zohar, Olechet Megureshet or Metorefet. Then the mother started going crazy, Metorefet means crazy, and Megureshet, and divorced. Ubanin Tzofchim, and her son screaming. Vayefochim Shelakhu Otam Tzoakim Vebochim. Or the chicks are screaming and crying. As you Sandal, then this angel, the name is Sandal, Olive Zachu Alofin Dile, Al Nefasho Asiya. It say, in different section of the Zohar, that because the mother is going crazy, it creates enough mercy for the world. What does that even mean? Tell us Tikkunei Zohar. It have mercy on Nefashot de Asiya. We know that we have five worlds: the world of action, the world of formation, the world of creation, the world of emanation, and the world of what we call Adam Kadmon, primordial man, which the lowest one is Asiya. Now, within Asiya, you have five types of fulfillment. It starts with Nefesh, then Ruach, then Neshama, then Chaya v'Yechida. So, when that pain happened to the mother, there is enough availability, accessibility from the angel Sandal to pour enough light to the nefashot of Asiya. V'ima lekut shabarichu, v'akteu b'ach, v'achamam lekul ma'asav, im ken amai gizrat alayu ofa l'nefashot, da'asiya, v'kar mekina amalchut shabarolam Asiya, v'ken matat di'itzira. So through that, it's awakening the mercy side of the Creator. And the same thing happening for us, for Yetzirah, for the world of formation, for the world of formation, we have Matat, we have the angel Matat. And the angel Matat is a different level, it's a higher level than Sandal, because the angel Matat is the king of all angels. That's why we call it Matat, is the king of all angels. Olive Zachu Alofin Dili De Uruchin Achen Bibne Rasha. Now, Kol Mishet Lopkinat Ruach Di Yitzira. But what does that mean, that Matat is taking care of that specific person? It means that that specific person, as a Ruach, the second level of the soul, comes from Yitzira, from formation. That's why it's connected to Matat. Mishet Baruch Di Yitzira. Mfaresh Deva Kusaya Nu Nishmadin, Olam Abriya Nemshachot Nishmad Laurim Laim. And from Olam Briya, which is what we call Banim, we studied last time, as sons. So the soul that coming from there, coming from Briah. It doesn't say Bina of Briah, like you say before, Ruach de Yitzirah, or at least Neshama de Briah. It just say Briah, just say the world of creation. Then the Neshamot that is there, it's a different level. It's come from Kursaya, coming from the chair, coming from the throne. ומהי חיה רוחין, ומעולם היצירה נמשכים הרוחות. From the world of formation, we're drawing the ruach, because that's what belongs to. ומאופן נפשין, ומעולם היצירה נמשכות הנפשות. From עשייה, we're drawing the נפש. ומפרש וינון בבריאה, יצירה ועשייה לקרים כיסא חיה ואופן. So this is three levels. The levels in the highest level, which is Bria, where the Neshama comes from, it's called Kiseh, throne, or chair. Chaya, Chaya mean animal, but Chaya also mean livelihood, from the word Chaim. This has come from Yetzirah, this is the energy of Yetzirah, and Ofan coming from Asiya. So we have three levels, that's called Kiseh, Chaya, veOfan. Ofanim, lower, Chayot, HaKodesh, or Chayot, second, which is Yitzira, and then Kiseh HaKavod is in the level of Bria. And we continue. Now, בשבתות ויומים טובים, שאלתי זוכות ישראל, נרן דאצילות, מבחינת תוספת נרן. In Shabbat, I have a feeling like I say it, but I gotta say it again, I guess. In Shabbat, in holiday, Shabbat Shachol Yisrael, Naran Da Atzilut, what happened especially doing Shabbat or doing Chagim, the Israelites receive Naran Da Atzilut. Why we should get excited about Chagim? Rosh Hashanah is coming. Why should I get excited about it? What's the secret? Because then you can receive Naran Da Atzilut. You're receiving from a place that you're never going to receive. Maximum you can receive from Bria. Doing the holiday, receive from Atzilut, from the world of emanation. Bebchinat Tosefet Naran Shel Shabbat. For that reason, those of you who pray with Kavanot, those of you who pray with meditation, we know that there is Nefesh Ruach Neshamah that you get. During Friday night, there is Nefesh Ruach Neshamah that you get Saturday morning. So every time you have the Naran, how are you getting it? From Atzilut, which is a great deal. As Dachtin, Aluy Neshamatin, Vuchim Neshamah, Ruach Atzilut, Mibina, then everything that we receive coming from Bina, Zerampin or Malchut of the system of Atzilut, of the system of emanation. It's not just any system. So yes, we still receive Neshama, Ruach veNefesh, the same like before. But this time, the location where it's come from is the world of emanation. That before it came either from Bria, for the world of creation, or from the world of formation, or for the world of action. This time it's all coming from Atzilut. What a gift. Shabbat, what a gift. Holiday. Think about it. I mean, it's tremendous. דהינו לרוחה דקושה מזרצפין, כי בינה כוללת גר, וזכרה ונוגבה, זין תחתונות, הרי יוצפירות. Because when we look at it from how the system works, בינה is 10 ספירות there. גימל ראשונות, וזכרה ונקבה. So Zayin Tachtonot and Gimel Rishonot together is 10. So we have 10 Sefirot. V'lemna oliv zachu al ofin dilin deinu nishmatin deparim lebna yasha. Dainu lomnin Gimel Rishonot b'riyatzayim melamdin zchut al p'chinat naran nishachot me'em. U'batayim melamdin zchut. V'zvalav Yisrael mekamim ayim kudat ishluach haken. When you can actually have a chance that those angels, those forces speak good about you, when a person do the mitzvah, of Shiloh HaKen. When a person is focusing on doing the mitzvah of Shiloh HaKen. So without doing this mitzvah, this is not being awake. For that reason, Tikkunei Zohar is makpid, is specifically being very meticulous about talking about how this mitzvah is connecting to all this wonderful thing that we can get. So it's two things. The meaning of the mitzvah, and what the actual mitzvah can do for you. The meaning of the mitzvah is related to the Shechina, Banim, Efrochim, Betzim, you know, but the actual mitzvah is releasing that energy that you might be able to receive while you're doing the mitzvah. Because the minister who in charge of those birds, that we relate the mitzvah for, when you push the word away, there is minister for everything. Shebaolam hazeh. Em melandim zchut alem shenigyoshu bekenem. They right away look for creating mercy for the birds being pushed away from their nest. The kusha bruch of zera bin da'atzilut ma'avid, kanit lekul achrin, dine da'atzilut v'yamei, v'yamah v'kikol memanah de'ofed de'la tatat b'rei l'etzirasya, ulif zachu lo'ofin dine memanah aliu, ala naram nimshachot nebi'a, ולית באחו מאן דוליף זכון בנאי הנפשות ורוחות בזכן מזכר ונוגבה דעצלות. נילוס רן שלהם נאמר בני בחור ישראל. By doing that mitzvah that looks such a cruel act to push the mother away from her family, that cruel act almost activating a merciful act to remind the universe, the galaxy, the God, the divine, that also Bnei Israel doesn't have their nest. Bnei Israel doesn't have their place like it used to be with the Shekhinah, with the temple. And it's awakening from Atzilut, because Bnei Israel come in from Atzilut. I know Aruchot v'nefashot shebezachar v'nukva d'Atzilut, and it reminds the Creator that also, I mean, is the Creator need a reminder? No, it's been activating a memory of the Creator to do the idea of bringing the Shekhinah out of the Galut. Because if the birds screaming and yelling that they separate me from my children, the Shekhinah screaming and yelling that you separate me from the Israel, from the Israelite. She doesn't have the temple. She doesn't have that. That mitzvah is activating the reality existent of what the Shekhinah is going through during the Galut, during the exile. And from this, the concept that Jerusalem is not been built. That's what the Shekhinah can no longer sit in their nest. What is the nest of the Shekhinah? Jerusalem. Jerusalem. If Jerusalem not been built, there is no nest. If there is no nest, where is the Shekhinah going to sit? And for that reason, their children are no longer with her. They are not in the nest too. Where are they? Begalutah tachat yadei adonim kashim omin de'alma. Ha'meshubadim mebnei Israel. The Israelite becomes slave to the other nation because of the Galut time. Because of the Galut, now they become slave. They're no longer with their mother. And because of that, they have to cry and yell, very similar to what the gozalim, what the chicks are going through. And nobody asks for mercy for them. And somebody can speak good on them. At that time, there is screaming from God's point of view. But what does that mean, God's point of view? God is screaming now? What does that even mean? That God is kind of tzavach. You know, what does that mean? So it say, Zeran pin da atzilut. Kutcha barichu is always Zeran pin. But when we talk about this level, is the Eran pin of atzilut. Vamar lemani lemani yaseh veyaseh leman shvi. The Creator find out, and nobody can fix that situation that they get out of the exile. And again, exile doesn't mean that you live in outside of Yerushalayim. Exile means you can live in Yerushalayim, but the Shekhinah is not there. The Shekhinah is not there. You're still in exile. That's called exile. Rotzei lomar ani elmod aleihem zchut. So God said, I myself will teach great things about them. So instead of waiting for somebody to do the work, God doing the work. And because of that, automatically, there is a mercy force that being awake on us, but it is the Torah Chavim al Hashchina v'al Bnei Yisrael shebagalut. And right away, there is a mercy being activated on Bnei Yisrael that coming from the Creator. Now there is another section here I want to read. Again, I want to make sure, when I use the word sandal, it sounds like sandals, because it is in the bottom. It is connected to Asiya, but it's not his real name. It's sandal, and then you add another three letters, which is Fon. You cannot say his whole name. Just checking if there is an additional thing that I need to share with you. So today, that's the part I want to read to you. Yeah. So it says, Kadosh Baruch Hu, מה הוא עושה? מאסף לכל החיילות שלו ואומר, הרי כל ממונה של העופות של המטה, בבריאה יצירה לומד זכות על העופות שלו. God said, in בריאה יצירה עשייה, every force, remember, in בריאה is the kise, is the throne, in Yetzira is Matat, in Asiya is Sandal. So, God said, in every level, everybody is in charge of their bird. In Bria Yetzira Asiya. What about Israel? Who's going to speak good about them? Because it says, Bni Bechor Israel, if you remember, when the Israelite left Egypt, Moses came with the message from God. It said, Bni Bechori Israel. My firstborn is Israel. But the Shekhinah, who is in the Galut, and the Kedah, and the Ubanav in the Galut, and the Umot Olam. And who is in the Galut, and the Umot Olam. And who is in the Galut, and the Umot Olam. And who is in the Galut, and the Galut. So God himself is redeeming us from the exile. God himself bringing the Shekhinah back to Eretz Israel, to Yerushalayim. Yeah, I think I'm going to stop here because I want to start talking about the details of Shiloh HaKen, but maybe we